Hi, everybody. I'm Tian. I'm going to talk about how to enable AI in drug discovery where there is no big data. Big data in drug discovery is an illusion. If you measure by pure volume, we do have some big data. For example, we have 2.3 million compounds and their interaction information with 500 proteins. That is a huge matrix. But if you're serious about helping a patient, you're going to see a different perspective. First of all, there are more than 20,000 human proteins. That means the 500 is a very small portion. Secondly, most of the compounds don't bind to the protein. That means the known success story we can learn from are even less. Finally, majority of the protein that is studied come from the same few protein families. That means our experience to deal with the proteins significantly different will be even less. To give you more statistic to group proteins by similarity into protein families, in the most well-studied protein family, less than 1% of the protein are illuminated, defined as a protein who have at least one binding compound. And in the whole human genome, 19.2% of protein families are totally dark, meaning that we only know those proteins exist, but we've never been able to really measure them. Even with this excitement of AlphaFold2, which is AI-based protein structure prediction tool, studies show that it only illuminates half of the dark protein space. And it gives you only structure, meaning that it's far from enough to predict the protein function. So smart investors will ask, why don't we generate more data? The truth is, this tiny portion of illuminated protein already took scientists all over the world decades to generate. It is infeasible, even with a lavish of investment, to generate big data for every specific task, for every specific disease, all the proteins related. And this dark protein problem is only one of the no big data scenarios along the long journey of drug discovery. Living in the era of big data, the true game for drug discovery is actually how do you better utilize the small data and generalize, predict into the unknown dark space. If AI equals pure data-driven, it will not be of much use for drug discovery. Because in a pure data-driven logic, all dark proteins are outliers, which AI is not expected to be responsible for the outliers. And according to pure data-driven logic, you are expected to discard all outliers. Is it true that AI has to be data-hungry for every specific task? We believe that AI can do better. You just need a different kind of AI for drug discovery. And AI not only data-driven, but also biology-informed, mechanism-guided, so that you can increase unit value of every drop of precious biology data. As a famous saying goes, nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution. So for the dark protein problem, this is the logic we want to build into the AI model in addition to the limited data. So what we do is first train the model to capture the evolution knowledge from all the whole protein, human protein sequence data, then carries this knowledge into the structure and function space, then this is biology informed. Then you train the model to be informed that the function is determined by structure. This is called mechanism guided. After you get this biology logic built into AI, when you come into the limited data of protein function, dark proteins are not outliers anymore. They are a big background. Of course, it's easier to say than done. There's a lot of AI design work needed to make it real, but at least I want you to be informed that AI doesn't have to be confined by your limited data as long as you design AI in the right biology logic. Using this system, we have identified novel drugs for opium use disorder where the target are the dark proteins, and its performance surpassed the rational design comparing to medicinal chemist. Dark protein-related disease now have new hopes. And this dark protein illumination is just one example to show you that data-driven doesn't have to be data-hungry. If you're interested in more of such advancement, check out research in our lab. Thank you.